Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert Bobi Wine tatika era tegezebwamu kutibwa kati no jino Museveni gobobuza yabigezezako gichimukomeza bakata mauli agava ku mutendera gwensi yonna koti yensi yonna ICC naye yingide mu nsonga zino ekitongole kyensi yonna ekyebyokwerinda agite NATO nayo yingide mu nsonga zino era nga jino Museveni agatandise okumumyuka atandise okubiribirira nga yebuuza lwaki yabikoze lwaki yagezezako okwedigira ku Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert Bobi Wine na anteri jiwako kubaka tebi gamba tebi fuse mbilala. Na usoyo nkula gen kuwebi gambo vino obiulire bulungi nobo egende deza ogenda kumaino jeno Museveni watuse ICC okumukwata iragide ate kubango bujuri zigo yonge deo kuvayo obobu temu no kuchobole dembeli obu ntumuguangali ya Uganda atenga bukula dela Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert Bobi Wine ya twalo musango mukoti yensi yona ICC nga wakanyebio hivi kolo bedobi.
Country where people who are educated are just acting stupid, and when you talk to them, they start threatening you. Because Kituma, I know him. In fact, I asked him, "Have you joined the police to avenge the death of your brother?" Because I remember your brother was killed when we were in those debates when we were debating. Your brother was killed, and Kasiria Gwanga, who was part of the debate, told us he joined the army those days to avenge people who killed his brother. So, did you join the police to avenge the killing of your brother? I asked him a very tough question. So he has gone, he said, and when you see his tweets, that anybody who goes personal, I'll have to deal with it. I said, no, I'm not going personal. I'm asking you questions because you said this was not a gunshot. Bobi Wine was involved in a scuffle. You're a police spokesperson. I told him you don't deserve to follow Enanga's footsteps because Enanga lied and he was a brand liar, the professional liar, and you as a young man, you are taking a very wrong path. So he's busy fighting me. So I'm requesting people online to fight him for me also to show that I'm connected. Lucas, I submit.
Thank you. Yes, we will join you in that fight. Apologies for the delay, but yes, we will join you. So I believe you've shared the tweet in the platform. Guys, there should be tweets on the chat. Do follow Comrade James, like the tweet to start with, respond to it, and then retweet it so that, you know, you're really amplifying it. Yes, guys, we'll have a moment of silence. Comrade Godfrey, you come in next. Let's have a moment of silence, please. Thank you. Most of them have been knocked, literally knocked, you know, forced off the roads by the so-called police. I don't really like calling them police because these are not police, they are murderers. Murderers. They've proved it time and time again that they are murderers. They do not have any love for the Ugandans. They are not there to maintain law and order, but rather to cause chaos. You know, so I don't think they should be having the title of police. It is not right that they are called the police. How do you knock a pedestrian and even run them over, you know? And I do not want to describe because I know some people attend the Zoom with their kids and it is injustice. Yeah. So many of our brothers have gone to their graves so early. And just like Comrade James has shared, the lack of infrastructure, the lack of facilities, you know, you find that the people working for this ruthless dictator are dying way before him, because for him, he's got every facility he needs within his so-called state house. So for the rest, they've got to drive on those potholes. Even a pothole can kill a patient within no time, you know, because if you've got heart issues or you've got this terrible pain, or if you're broken, you have a fracture, even break further, because these potholes, they will just kill you. Yeah, so we've got poor service delivery. Guys, do request for the mic. Comrade Godfrey, do come in. Sorry for the wait. Mr. Kato, you come in. Nyerere, you will come and speak to us. Thanks for observing the moment of silence, guys. Thank you. Yes, Comrade Godfrey. How are
Yes,
you?
I'm fine, Dorcas. How are you?
Good, thanks. Thank you so much for the protest. I know you're in the UK and you do always attend the demonstrations. Thank you so much, brother.
Yeah, we were most of us who normally attend were there. Our brother Kato Alvarez, you name it, our mobilizer as well. Now, regarding, I got two kind of issues to make a comment on. One was the attempted assassination on our president and how the security behaved. Now, I'll go give it to these guys, the Eddie Mutwez, because they are not to train security men. They have no guns and they've never been in combat situation. So everything they learn on the job. And the first instinct was to, for him in anger, to chase at whoever was running away and try to pull a gun out. Until they started trying to coach and shoot back, yeah. Then he comes back. He didn't run that he was scared, no. Far from it. This is a guy who has been with the president through thick and thin, but they are not 100% trained security, close protection,
No.
personnel. So if we want to get them to that high level, yeah, we can, we either have to get them out of the country, and that will be the almost near impossible. You can do online courses, but that's almost won't really teach you much about close protection. But all in all, they're doing a good job. They are humans. When they see their own heart, yeah, even if it was me, the thinking changes. You are thinking over a thousand things in a second. So you might do this one would have done second, first, and vice versa. But even with the trained professionals with no real arms, you go police who are armed to kill, they can do anything they want there. And in fact, the fact that you have this security of our president, that he wasn't hurt on the top part, yeah, because of that security. Yeah. So they will try
Okay, Ken. Yes.
to do diversions. Yeah, they might shoot on the other side, so you run off, leave the president exposed. But you still had the security around him, which saved him. Yes, they got the leg, but that's the best of the worst we can really have expected. Because if it was any other part, it would have been almost a catastrophe. Away from that, now, commenting on those who were protesting to the parliament, I think they were the three naked girls. When you are dealing with a regime and its enforcers or useful idiots who won't listen on any language, to attract their attention, you go do something out of the ordinary. It's not that you are disrespecting, it's that the only way to get that message heard worldwide or tell the audience is for you to do what they did. The nakedness is, doesn't imply that they wanted to show their
rather pass on their route? No. Intellectually, it means something. If you look at how Dr. Stella used to protest, yeah, to gain attention for the institutions which would not listen, that's the way you do it as a last resort, non-violent. So if they turned around, throwing stones and fire bombs, then you say they were violent. But peacefully, that's the way they could do it, attract attention, and they did do their job, and they made a point. And that, me, I'll applaud it. Yeah? If that's the only means you got left, so be it. You go many ways to skin a cat. And also, the last point I would say is,
yes,
peacefully, we are in trying to do the non-violent protests to get rid of the regime. Now, being too nice to the regime, they are getting used to that we don't bite. Yeah? Most of Ugandans, you see, they spend most of the time in churches. Yeah. Well, I don't know what they are praying for, but things don't change. So you go have a hybrid way of showing the regime that, yes, we are tired of you, but we are not frightened of you, but we'll do anything. If you provoke us as a last resort, we might resort to violence. But we hope it doesn't reach that, because we won't touch guns. We are not going to the bush. But we go to the streets. That's what I have to say at the moment. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Comrade Iga. And thank you so much for all that you continue to do. Comrade Ismail, I don't know, Comrade Ellen Prezo, if you can take a few hands. That would be great signal to let me know. Yes, Comrade Patel, please do come in. The co-hosts, actually, you do have the powers to unmute and mute people. Please do come in and... Yes, Comrade, Brother Patel, hi, how are you?
Very exhausted after a very busy day yesterday, and I want to say thank you to my, you know, this revolution has really made me see life in a different way. You know, when in the Bible, when Jesus was the disciples came looking for Jesus, said where his people they came and they said, Jesus, your family, your brothers and sisters are looking for you. Actually, he disregarded them. He said, no, these are my people with one mission to make sure then highlight, speak for the voiceless people, speak and highlight. And that is it. And physical protest is also very, very important. I think that is one of the things. Muhammad Sereko couldn't come and greet us as fellow Ugandans. He ran away, and there are a few who braved it, and they were taking videos here and there. But we challenged some, but generally, do you know what? Down south where I come from, it was raining like nothing. It rained the whole day. But they say the sun shines on the righteous. There we are. No single rain on us. So that is a good report. But again, I want to say something. Yes, it has been very sad, the incident. It was a proper near miss. But we very know that God is in charge of our country, is in charge and is protecting our president and many other people. And it's unfortunately other people are still in prison, and that is what we are highlighting on, we are talking about. And so one thing I can say is the devil is so shallow-minded Anybody who works for the devil doesn't really know the repercussion of what they're trying to do. Actually, if you contact, if you attack somebody, you attack somebody and you make that person even more popular. And now this one, and the reason as to why I'm saying this, on Good Friday, if Satan knew that Jesus was going to resurrect on Sunday, he wouldn't have gone again with that plan. He will have just said, no, let's leave it. But now he knows he's defeated completely. And so even now, the regime know they are completed. That's why they wanted to follow up to the hospital to finish the job. But thank God, we thank people from Zambia who really stood so firm, and then and then hence the president's safety back home. We are so grateful to a few Ugandans who are really, I think majority. But one thing that really, that morning of Tuesday, I don't know how many of you read the headline of the Monitor, where there's this woman who sits in a comfortable place. He thinks every Ugandan have eggs and milk. And she says, "Oh, give your children milk and egg." That really made me sick. I became so numb that whole day. And no wonder why it led to this. And one of the things I've been telling people, they'll say these things with arrogance because they know we don't have the stomach to do it. We don't have the stamina to stand up with all. We don't have the spine to really react to whatever they're saying. In drips and pops, they say the tweets that you see by the drunkard. You see all these things. And yes, I agree with so many people that we need to change course. We need to change course. You don't have to be there available for you to be arrested. If anything, we should help our foot soldiers, those who are prominent, those who are on the ground. We should begin thinking militarily. Not that I'm saying violence, but you have to think tactics, you have to change tactics. You don't have to avail yourself, make yourself vulnerable to these people. This is what I'm trying to say. And another thing, when Mugenyi, Dr. Mugenyi was talking about helicopter, you think these people care about Uganda? There's how many military helicopters are there? They'll only take their own. They'll use it for prom. They'll use it for you. Sometimes I laugh about these things, but they're very serious. I had a cousin of mine who thinks I'm bitter about what is happening in Uganda. And I told him, "What are you doing here? You go home. You go home and you experience it. Things there are different." And this is a guy who has been here in the UK and he hasn't been back home, I don't know since when, nearly over 20 years. And do you think things are the same? And I was talking about how they're grabbing land in Gulu and Apa and the rest of it. He said, "Where's Robert Mao?" And he's using the word resign. I said, "Do you know that that word does not exist in Uganda? It's not there in the vocabulary of Ugandans. Resign for what?" So there we are. So yeah, that is enough rant for today. But we need to, what I'm trying to say is, and Reginald said something so nice. I like that thinking. We need to know things are bad, so how are we making it better? That is now how I look at things. What can I do to make sure? That's why you don't see my video now on I'm off video, because you don't, these are, we're dealing with stupid people who don't even care. And Uganda is our land, is our home, and we are going to be going back to Uganda, and we will be visiting Uganda. And for God and my country, I beg to stop. Thank you.
Thank you so much, comrade. Comrade Kato, and thank you so much for that demonstration. Yeah, it is painful. I did hear Janet Museveni, not really president, whatever. I did hear how she's saying the kids should have milk and eggs. You know, they've failed the Karamoja. People in Karamoja are dying to this present day. They failed to provide even the very basic. And now she's talking of milk and eggs. Where are they going to come from? Fall from heaven? So thank you. Thank you so much, comrades, for the demonstration yesterday. I know you're exhausted. Do take a rest, and thank you so much for making it here to the Zoom. Comrade Nyerere, you've been muted for the longest time. Please do come in, and sorry to keep you. Comrade Ismail, hopefully you'll be able to take this on. Thank you. Yes, comrade, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
We are good, thanks. Thank you.
Yes, please.
If Where are you joining
Yeah,
us from?
I'm joining you from Uganda, and I am a former aspirant, that is Kisinga Town Council from Rwenzururu. And you know what the dictator did to our people? Sometime back in 2016. So we very much want him as go as we very much want him gone as early as yesterday. And we thank you guys in the diaspora for always being there for us and for always feeling our what we feel here, for always showing that for sure you belong to Uganda, our motherland, and that spirit of unity is what we need and is what we want and is what we want to continue. Just as our president said when he was that side, that feel what we feel back home. Do what we do some place apart for us, where we've been blocked, where we've been beaten, where we've been arrested, killed. Do your best to play our part where we can't. Yes, and I will try to support the idea of reggae. Yes, of personal protect VIP protection level 4. And I, for one, had also thought about it, and I said no. We need at least some guys in black with shades to be around our president, His Excellency Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, Bobi Wine. Yeah, so some of us are ready to take on lessons with him, and then maybe with time or even immediately, as early as now, we can join the security team at that level. More on to then this one goes directly to the powers behind the throne. That is our big brother, the USA, then the UK. And what I know, someone would cut it out and send it to the respective authorities, is that they know that they are the architects of Ugandan politics and the architects of our economy. And we thank them. What I know, they are doing something great behind the curtains. And what we request them is to continue supporting us so that we can also be able to emulate the bees. When the queen in the hive is attacked, and there is a danger, you will see the bees surrounding the queen and then swarming and taking the queen away. So that is what I am looking at, level 4 VIP, in that we have to always surround our president and then we take him out in the right direction, as Reggie said. where we can find something like a barrier to protect him from any further danger. Then, what I know, the powers behind the throne know that this war is between the dictators versus the Democrats. I would outline the four, that is Russia, Iran, North Korea, and China. So they have to also know that we on the ground back home, we are facing that if I might call it, that big and dangerous power. So in their plans, they should also look at that and also see a way of engaging us. And as Reggie said, we must have skills, more skills, to also have our foot soldiers back on the ground level zero, that I might call, or level one. For example, back in my town council, Kisenga Town Council, located in Kasese District, Rwenzori Mountains, in the Rwenzururu Kingdom, so that we are able to empower our teams. Yes, the teams that have gone beyond being losing enthusiasm because of being called idiots, then they are made to lose hope. Then after which, if you subdue to those that I've mentioned, then the dictator will rule you forever. So we have to learn how to destroy fear and create victory. All comrades out there, let us always look at destroying fear, and then we shall create victory. We have to be determined because we have an inspiring leader. He inspires us. He's confident. He has the courage. He's ready to go out there on the front line and cover us. So the best thing we have to do now is to cover him in all ways, in all ways, even if it means paying the last price. We have to be determined, and more than determined, knowing that the powers behind the throne are also with us. And what I know, they are with us. They can't allow their throne to be taken by some people like Russia, China, Iran, North Korea, to mention but a few, but those are the four major ones. Thank you. I submit.
Yeah, thank you very much, Angelele, for your submission. Maybe before I let you have a cup of coffee, what would you suggest that Ugandans need to do that they have not done enough, since we have not overpowered the security and the dictator is still oppressing us? So what would be your suggestion that we should do as Ugandans using nonviolent methods? Nyeri, are you there?
He was muted.
Yes. I was muted. Okay.
I'm there.
All right, did you hear my question?
Yes, what should we do and what nonviolent step should we take that would not take again? The question is around what to do is to destroy fear. Just as our presenter before did came in, talked about losing our fear and then raising our courage. Yes, we've done it, but not at the level that is required. So what I mean, our president sang Kasukari Tukongeremo. I think our president sang, I know most of you know that song, Kasukari Tukongeremo, and we should always listen to our president's messages in his songs. for example, fighting for freedom, Embera Imara Muamani, to mention but a few. So once we always take on those songs and listen to them, they will always raise our courage and they will always keep our memories afresh and they will always keep us updated on most issues that are happening to us. He sang most of them. You see, him being an artist, artists are prophets. Yeah, sorry for that. Artists are prophets. They sing about things to come. And what is to come, he has already sung about them. So the message is in there. Let us do our best. We either download the audios, those who can download the videos, and some of us who are out there and who are able to support these others. You see, when the dictator makes you poor, then he can step on you and do anything to you because he knows that poor people and for that matter, weak people cannot fight back. So what we should do, we should also try to empower our people in all ways we can, in whichever we can to reach them, and then raise their courage, support them in all ways, support them financially, support them in everything that can enable them, raise their courage, and then move on to the front line, and then fight for their rights, fight for their freedoms. Yeah, so basically, it could have been lengthy, but I think the solution is in there, non-violently. Yeah, it's all about courage. Then it will help us to destroy fear and create victory. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much, Nyerere, for your answer to my question. Fear are false evidence that appear to be real. That is what fear is all about. Now, before I go into what happened on Tuesday, in regard to the attempted assassination to our president's, His Excellency Robert Chagwe Ssentamu, by the regime police. We need to take a memory lane back and interrogate ourselves as Ugandans. His Excellency Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu put everything on the line to start with. He was and is still a celebrity because for the last 25 so years, years, he has been singing songs, passing his messages through those songs, and was at peace. He could fly out of the country and, go to organize shows. People pay him to attend his shows. They pay to see him. In Uganda, anyone who would want to come and sing at their event or concert, he would charge them between 5 to 10 million. Now, he put all that aside to give back to the people that have made him who he is right now. Has sacrificed himself for the country. He's not looking for money. He's not looking for positions because he's a celebrity. He would just sit back and say, okay, let me not get involved in this kind of things that are threatening my life. He's a father. with young children. What does that speak to us as Ugandans? He's fighting for himself and for the Ugandans. He's leading the way, our generation, to make sure that the country is liberated from the capture it is in at the moment. We must, as Ugandans, shield him, give him all the support. Much as he can have official security details, but Ugandans, we Ugandans, we must at all times protect him. And anyone who touches him is not touching an individual, is no longer an individual, a person of Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu like or Bobi Wine, as many people saw him in the last 10 years, is leading our revolution. So we have a duty as Ugandans. Anyone who tries to attack him is attacking us, either online or physically. Try to insult him. I've seen many people insulting him, trying to mock him. We cannot tolerate that. I'm not saying that people should use violence. We are peaceful people, and everything that we do must be nonviolent. If people try to mock him online, we must go after them and put them to the place where they belong, because they're not attacking him as an individual. They are attacking our revolution. I know many people will think that we're worshiping him. We're not worshiping him. We are standing and protecting, guarding our revolution. That's the noble cause. What he stands for as the values. He would sit back and then enjoy his money. They pay him, people come to watch him, pay him, goes to whatever he wants to go. Miami, move around the world, enjoy himself with the family. Ugandans, our number one enemy is General Yoweri Museveni. But before you look at your enemy, you must dissect your enemy, understand your enemy, understand your powers, understand your strength, understand your weaknesses, and understand your threats. How much time do we take as individuals to reflect on the actions that we make? Where those actions that we take are aiming at propelling the revolution or push it backward. We're dealing with a tyrant. How do you deal with the person that captured your state? Do you have to wear gloves while handling him or handling that system? We have no You see, our state was captured. I want that to sink into our mind. Our country was captured. Now, once you get to know that the state was captured, you devise means on how you deal, operate in a captured state. If a state is captured, that means the institutions are non-existent. The parliament that you see, the judiciary, and the executive, those are the three arms of government, are under one roof, managed and controlled by a few people that run and manage and control the country. Some of them are not even in the structures of administration. So when you see that police officer, where does that police officer get the directive? Where does he get the instructions? The person that commanded and say, shoot him, where does he get the instructions? When those police officers are being trained, what kind of message are they being given while treating or engaging leaders of political parties or other political players? How do they see the National Unity Platform? That million answers, I mean million questions with a few answers. As Ugandans, we have not done enough. We have to blame ourselves. We are a couple of people here on this Zoom. It should be our responsibility to do something every day. Every day. If you are to get where we want to be, we must play our roles. I know we all playing our roles in different ways, but this is a marathon. Make no mistake to even think that the regime is not interested in taking the life of our leader. They're interested and they're planning to do that. They have tried many times to throw a stone in the bush and see what comes out. Now, if they keep, this is almost the fourth time they've tried that. How do we guard our leader to make sure that the fifth time doesn't come? Because these guys are there. They capture the state and they want to maintain power by all means. That's why when you go to the police, it's all filled up by the military. When you go to the judiciary, before they make any judgment, that they will get orders, maybe get phone calls. And these are professionals that spent 7 years at the university in LDC. But they cannot practice what they studied. Someone in Gulu, maybe Salim Saleh, or one gentleman, I mean, someone in Nakasero will give them a call. So as Ugandans, when you see someone attacking Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, is not attacking an individual, is attacking the struggle to liberate a country, Uganda. And if we are to stop the innocent Ugandans being abducted, tortured, killed, imprisoned, the Olivia Rutayas being incarcerated, the Kivumbis are arrested and charged with concocted charges. All that is not going to stop. But what is the enemy? What is in the mind of our oppressor, of our enemy? Why do they plant whatever they're planting to incriminate the person that they arrested? Who they know that is innocent, that's why they don't have evidence to prosecute them. They will come up with concocted charges as holding charges to keep them behind the bars. Because they understand Ugandans, we Ugandans, we speak about something and stop talking about it, then we move on to something else. We're not talking about the missing 18. We're no longer talking about the Olivia Rutayas who are incarcerated and more people are being added there. If we cannot reach where Genome 7 is, as powerful as he is, using our taxes to buy those guns and tear gas, those trucks that is using to torture, oppress us, we have to look at everyone who is enabling him. Some of the things that we must do as Ugandans, and we must do them as quick as yesterday. The enablers, people are enabling him, come from our society. These MPs, these local leaders are living in our communities. We must make it so hard for them to find peace. When they come to your region to hold a parliamentary sitting, the people in that community, in that region, must stand up. Don't wait for people from Kampala to come again to Masaka. We have hundreds of thousands of people in Masaka and around there. So, the non-violent activities that we can do, one is isolation. No politicians would want to be isolated. That's why they spend so much time to give you presents, they engage with you. Now, next year, there's going to be nomination for the general election for MPs and those who want to become president. Next year, it's going to be a year of nominations. Now they're probably coming to your villages to organize sports events and all other things. But these are the people that never delivered for you. How do you play your part? So, isolation, civil disobedience, when they invite you on an event, Ugandans must really protest by not attending those events. Whether you support, whether you subscribe to NUP or FDC or DP, or you have no party, you are Ugandan. That's what we must understand. It's not a normal practice of politics in Uganda. We are in a liberation. So every day should be protest. Some people will go on the street, others will go and disrupt conferences and conventions organized and pass on the message. Others can protest through disobedience, civil disobedience. Others can protest through isolating those that enables Genome 7 to continue oppressing us. The other one is boycotting, as I conclude, Dorcas. Boycotting. We have seen this new thing opening in Uganda, the so-called Chinatown. You see, Ugandans are enemies to ourselves. Ugandans are flocking that place. We hate ourselves. And you don't even know the quality of the things they're selling you. You go to buy. They're telling your TVs would have been for 1 million and they're giving it to you at 200,000. And the Ugandan's going to buy it. So you think the other person loves you so much to give you a 1 million worth at 200,000? And then that money will go back to China. Then you say our country is not developing. What about these other people that go to get things from China, right? Bring them to Uganda and sell them. These are Ugandans. I would want to see the traders protesting and demonstrating against that Chinatown shopping mall and all the things that are being sold there. Because if we have buy Uganda, build Uganda, and then you have the Chinamen opening up, they're the one manufacturing those things and they're the one selling them. And the Ugandans are massively going to go and buy. They're not taking them for free. Actually, even those the Chinese people might be surprised, because some of the things that might be in those shops might be for just dumping. They would even give them free of charge. But if they say Ugandan paying, I think they must be laughing in their language. How stupid we are. So we must, go back and ask ourselves questions. Who is keeping Museveni in power? Because Uganda has 45 million. And when you look at the police, the army, about 300,000. All of them, all the security guys, they don't exceed 300,000. We must refocus on what we're doing. I submit.
Thank you so much, Comrade Ellen Prezo. And of course, thank you so much for all that you continue to do. Apologies for the feedback in my background. Yeah, I was actually interrupting to ask if you know the name of those comrades. You know that comrade that was on ground. Let me try and get that on the screen. You know, it shows broad daylight, these guys kicking, brutalizing our brothers. You know, I try to put it up. I don't know if my screen is showing this bit.
I don't know the comrade.
You see the kicking and the
yeah, I don't know, but again, you see, when the police.
Awo gino Museveni w'atuuse era ensi w'emutuusizza ebikolobero bingi bulijjo abikola nga ye yeeyita wa kitalo, nga yeeyita naggwano, yeeyita wa kabi ddenja era ng'agamba nze Ssaabalwanyi, nze master of violence, kati violence amutuusizza okufuluma obukulembeze. Akyabirabanga byakusaaga, akyabirabanga byakiyitamu ne sikiyita mu luggya. Kino kintu kigendera agendera ddala wala kuba buli agency evaayo, buli bakulembeze abavaayo, buli mukulembeze avaayo munyiivu olwakino Museveni kyakoze okwagala okutemula Kyagulanyi Ssentamu Robert Bobi Wine. Era buli omu agamba lwaki oba otta munno kubanga muvuganya. Atakutte mmundu nti akubye kyasi, atakutte mayinja nti agakkubye, atalina kyakukoze wabula ng'akuvuganya mu mateeka agakkirizibwa mu nsi yonna. Guno ogamba nti ojja kusalawo yo omujembulamu obw'ensi. Kati buli omu agamba tekisoboka, tekikkiriza. Okwo okutyoboola eddembe ly'obuntu, eyo violation tusobola kukkirizibwa, ate n'obwo obutemu tebusobola kukkirizibwa. Kino Museveni amaze ebbanga ddene nnyo ng'akweka obutemu bwe, ng'ensi agikweka, nga tagiraga mbu nno mutemu, ng'atemula naye n'azaako neyefuula kirala. Kati ensi eri bweti emutunuulidde, buli kikolobero kyakola Kyagulanyi ng'akiteekayo ng'ensi eraba nga yeelolera. Nga bagamba yi ono jjo atugamba promoting a demokrasia, ate yakola bino ebikolobero. Kati nno kano ko kamutuddemu era akawulira kamusimbidde ddala ewala wasinga okuluma. Yejjusa lwaki yakoze kino ekintu ate nga tebinnakoma, tebinnaggwa, tekigenda omutuusa y'anaamanyaayo. Omukama bakuume, mwerabu.